So the very first thing that you need to learn Angular is what? Like you need Node.js, a software called Node.js. This is a single requirement you have. This is a single requirement, okay? Node.js yeah. Software. Node.js. So first you have to go and install it, okay? So if you are using Windows operating system, then according to that you can, you know, download like for Linux, for Windows, for Mac. So they have a different package over here. Go for 64-bit because most of the computer is 64-bit nowadays. So go for 64-bit. So you have to download and install it, okay? Once you download and install it, then you need to just cross check that my environment is correctly set up, okay? Just ensure, okay? Yes, there is something. So just open your command prompt to just ensure that yes, I installed and this is the correct. What happens sometime that even you install the it is not correctly mapped with the environment variable. You might be knowing there is an environment variable in operating system, so it is not.
Yeah,
it cause a problem. So just ensure that. Node is there. So what you have to type? Simply go type node-v. V means version. So you will see that version is coming. It means that it is perfectly set at operating system level in an environment variable. Okay.
Yeah.
Then when you install a node, then an extra software get installed automatically. That is called npm. npm-v. Okay. So see the version is showing. Then you will ask me, hey, Shiv, like what is the difference between Node and NPM then? So Node is your fundamental software, the root software that is needed for your Angular development. And it is a runtime environment. Java has a runtime environment, right? JVM or something it is called, right?
Yeah.
So that is a runtime environment, right?
Mm-hmm.
But in Java itself, if you need to install some kinds of package, then you must be using in .NET we install a command npm. That is like there is a package that we install. But in Java, we must be installing some kinds of a package on top of that. So Node think of as a supporting software that giving the runtime environment. NPM help you to install multiple dependency, multiple software required in your in your Angular application. So let me give an example that you are running your Angular application, that's fine, and suddenly you need a bootstrap. So what you will do through the npm like this, npm you will write bootstrap and you download, you will download the bootstrap into your project. So npm is all about downloading the dependency, installing the dependency inside Angular project. So I will show you what that means. Okay. Then this two is there. Then you need some kinds of editor. You might be using Eclipse or NetBeans or.
Normally we in the previous project we were using the WebStorm, but now we are using the Visio.
Yeah, Visio. So what happened? What I use is a Visual Studio Code. This is very lightweight and this is very fast because of this reason. I use, but it is independent, like you can use anything, okay?
Yeah.
Visual Studio. Normally, most of the company use this one only, okay? I have seen lots of company using this one. So just go and download and install. According to your operating system, there are numbers of operating systems supported. So go and install it. Once you install, then you have to open this one, okay? This is a Visual Studio code dashboard or a UI
editor.
So over here, whatever you have done at a command line level to cross check and do all the things, you can simply close this. So inside and this terminal. Only there.
New terminal.
In a window we say command prompt, but in Linux and Unix language they say terminal. So they have added terminal word, okay? But normally it is a command prompt, you can say.
Okay.
Then from over here also, you can check the all the things like node-v, you will get that npm-v, npm, okay? So these two there, that's fine. But you need one more tool that is called CLI. Angular CLI. Okay, Angular CLI is totally optional, but now it become mandatory. Like it is very good. Like it help you to create the project, add the controller, lots of things. So make sure that Angular CLI is there. That is called NG. Okay, NG. So if you need to install Angular CLI, then just type like this: Angular CLI install. Okay, there is a site itself. So run. You have to run this command: npm install Angular CLI. So what you are doing? You are installing Angular CLI. What is Angular CLI? It is an internal tool, a command line interface that help you to create project, run the project, and add the component, lots of things. It give you lots of facility. Okay, like you use Eclipse for some reason, right? You can write your Java code in Notepad also, and you can compile, yeah, right? But you use Eclipse for what purpose? Because it gives some extra feature. It automate few of things. It is a developer friendly, right? The same, yes, reason you use Angular CLI. It is a developer friendly. It give lots of thing. So okay, so how you will install Angular CLI? You the npm command, and that is what exactly npm I was talking about. So you use npm to install any kinds of software or dependency required in your project. Okay, so go and run this command. So I will not run this command, okay, because already I installed, so I'm not going to run. And then just come and cross check ngv. Okay, it will tell you Angular CLI version. If you are running these three command and you are getting output, then you are perfectly set. Your environment is perfectly set, good to go. Okay, now software is installed, your all the configuration is done. Then now the second thing come is create a application, a simple application. Then what you will do? You will simply go to file, you will create a folder, open a folder. You need to click open a folder, because if you are working on a project, you will keep somewhere, right? So you have to create that folder. Raj, let's take an example, Raj only. So I am putting a Raj folder and selecting that. So what I am saying that, hey, Visual Studio, whatever I am going to do, so put everything under Raj folder. So see, I am connected with Raj folder. You can see, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, go to terminal again. It is your terminal and you are under Raj. See, it took automatically. It took automatically. See, you have opened the folder and it took the Raj path automatically. Now, to create a project, you will run a command, okay? ng new and a project name. So Raj demo. So see, you are using ng. What is ng? ng is Angular CLI. Angular CLI is indicated by ng in short. Okay, like your name is some might be bigger, but I am saying Raj in short. Same way, Angular CLI is termed as ng. So using ng, you can create your project. So ng is giving facility to create project. Otherwise, you need to do lots of thing to create a project. So ng is automating, helping you, developer friendly. That is why I told you ng. Okay, now simply run this command.
Is the ng standard?
Yes.
Or can I change ng to some other command also or no?
Yeah, you can use. If there is a tool, then you can use. But believe me, with Angular, ng and Angular go hand in hand. Like your left and right hand. Where you go, it will go hand to hand, right? So ng is like this only, okay? So people use ng only, not other things, but it is possible to use another thing, okay? But normally I have, you know, seen around more than 20 company I have worked with, they are using Angular and CLI only, okay? So, and even I have trained like many candidate, and I ask, take the feedback that internally in your company, what tool you are using? They tell that yes, it is Angular CLI and Visual Studio Code. Okay, this combination is pretty much there. Okay, so see, you have created a project over here by running that command ng new and the Angular, the project name. So your project name is over there, Raj Demo. Under that, there are numbers of files over here. So these files come automatically, and this is prerequisite. You have nothing to do with it. It is there to get started. You do not have to touch any file. You do not have to give your mind to this. Ignore completely, because this is there to support you, help you. Okay, so do not think like about all these things. Okay, but later in a real session, we will go and make you understand what is the significance, what purpose it serves. Okay, but for like normally, you do not have to touch this file. Otherwise, you will be messed up totally. What you have to do is go to under SRC. So it is like a Java equivalent. In a Java itself, there is a SRC, and under that your code is right.
Yeah.
So same way, it is there, SRC. So one, you have to understand SRC, and second is a node modules. So node modules, you do not have to touch, you do not have to do anything, do not touch it at all, just understand. Node is the dependency, okay? Like whatever built-in library you need, the things you need, it is this. So you develop a Java, then automatically under reference, we will see that numbers of built-in library has been added in your project as soon as you create a project, right? And use the service of that library. Same way, your node, under node, you have all the library that Angular will use, and it is there. So just remember that part and it's fine. Now over here, it said package installed successfully. So when you create a project, all the file will be created, and this message will come, package installed successfully. Then only you think that you are good. Okay, now I am here. See, I created a project, okay? All the files and folders related to development is under SRC, okay? Outs of SRC, forget everything. Just concentrate under SRC only. Now, to run the project, I have a project and I want to run it. So where you are currently, you are under Raj folder, but where is your project? Your project is under Raj Demo, right? So you have to go to Raj Demo, cd Raj Demo. Just change the directory. You are under Raj Demo now. Your project is under Raj Demo. Now, to run this project in a .NET, we click F5, but in Java, I don't know what is that. So we start the project. The same way to start the project, you have to run ng-o. You can write ng build. So it is there. Okay, just let me show that, because you do not need to remember. Okay. Sorry. It is there. I want you to show all the command that is related to ng, so you do not need to remember it all. So what you will use for what purpose. So just come over here. Okay, I think they have moved from here. Okay. So for building this project, if you want to build, then you have to run ng build. Or if you want to run the project and see in the browser, you have to do ng open -o. O means what happened? It will automatically launch into the browser. So simply click it. ng open o, okay. Run ng help. Okay, sometime it they change the command. Okay, just 1 minute.
Doesn't it serve? No. ng-serve?
Correct. ng-serve, okay? Sometime like, so ng-serve -o. So what it will do, it will build, ng-serve build and also launch into the browser. -o means opening into the browser, okay? Opening into the browser. If you do not O, then they will compile and they will give you a URL. Then you copy paste into the browser. But open automatically will open the browser. So let's see how it works. So it will take some time at the very first time. So let it come. So first time it take pretty much time. Okay, second onward it will be very fast.
Shiva, meanwhile, when we are building the first application, maybe you can show me us like a normal welcome or something like that in a store way.
Yeah. So see, this is what it is. Okay, this is your like So this is your normal page that come by default. Okay, this come by default. Okay. So now let's go and understand how it is not distributed. So you have to understand in your project, it might be 100 pages. So there will be some page that will come by default, right?
Yeah.
So how the architecture of it, try to understand it. So you have a app folder. Under app folder, you have all the files related to that. So there are some unnecessary files. So let me delete that. Okay, this is not required right now. So you have a CSS, you have a HTML, and you have a
CSS. But we use .css, not .css.
Come again?
We don't use .css. We are using .scss.
Yeah, that's fine. It can be anything. In a CSS, there are numbers of things, right? Like there are numbers CSS and all other things. So you can use. There is a no problem. So when you create a project, they ask you something over here. So let me show that.
Yeah, I did see it. See that. Do you want CSS or .scss? Yeah, we have chosen by default CSS. Yes.
Yes. So if I have selected CSS, they will create CSS. Yeah. If you have created, you have selected another thing, that will come. So that is not a problem. Okay. Now understand this CSS and HTML and TS, how three are connected to each other. They are a single file from the browser perspective, but as a developer perspective, it is a three file. So let experience that part. So I'm just giving H1, hello Angular. See, and you just save it. When you save it, it will compile automatically, and in the browser, it will be shown. So see, I just put hello and saved it. Control S. And it will be automatically reflected. So what happened, whenever you save, it automatically detect and it compile. So whenever you add anything new, okay, and save it, see, it compile automatically. You can see over here, and it will show over here. Now, so this is a HTML working fine, but if I want to give some style over here, some CSS apply, so you can go and add that. So if you H1 color, red. I'm just giving an example. So you are giving H1 as a red, and this will be applied automatically. See, it applied automatically. Now the question comes, how this CSS got to know that it is applied HTML, and how HTML referencing that CSS? It need to reference somewhere, right? Okay. So that is done by TS. So there is another file called TS. It is called TypeScript file, okay, .ts extension. So at the TS file, you have to understand this three block. One is a component and CSS. So you first is an import that come automatically, and you should remember that by default, everything imported from the core itself. So you are adding the library, like the way you use import in Java. This is the same thing. So it is very familiar to you. Now at the top of your class, you have a component. This is called attribute, okay, in .NET, I don't know what you tell in Java. So you are putting some decorator on top of your class, and over here you have a three element. You have to understand this three carefully, okay, because you will manipulate over here a lot. So selector is a unique name to this three. Like if you have a div and you put a particular name to div, right? Suppose you create a div you create a div and put lots of things under this, and then you give a particular ID, right? You give a particular ID. So what you are doing, you are giving a unique name to this div, and this div is a very fundamental unit that you can copy paste anywhere. You can put in the footer, then it will display in the footer. If you put in the header, it will display in the header, right? The same way, component is very much flexible. You can call from anywhere. Now come to, so selector is a unique name to this component, the this div. So in Angular, there is a concept of component, and component means CSS, HTML, and TS together. So together, this is called one component. So one div. So you can say one div, like to better understand. So you can say you have a one div. This three is a one div, but in a different block. So in a div itself, you can write a. So let me go and make you understand better way. So over here itself, you can style it, right? You can style it over here. So what you're doing, you're making a style, you're putting your content, and div is a HTML. So there is a three things over here you can see. This, but in a Angular, they are very, very much clean approach. So they have put separate file for CSS, they have put for separate HTML and separate coding, so that it is a clean approach, better maintained, okay? And a better, like many developers can work same time. Someone is working on CSS, someone is working on HTML, someone is working on TS. So it is a separation of concern, like MVC in Java, separation of concern. Okay, so selector is the unique name to this component, okay? And then you are adding like template URL, HTML, style URL, CSS. So you are attaching this. So you are telling ki, hey, this CSS is especially attached to this HTML. And you can put another HTML also. Then this CSS will be applied to this HTML. So it is a very, very, if you have a more CSS, like you created one more file, copy and pasted it. Suppose you created and included more one CSS file manually, and you want that to be applied, then just simply keep that CSS, test.css, and it will be applied. So it is very much configurable. So it
if
is-
I have a, can I, sorry, Shiva. So for example, in a, like you said, in style URLs, can I separate them with a comma or like how?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. I'm coming to that. I'm going step by step. Otherwise, there will be confusion to you.
Okay.
So you have HTML and you have a CSS. So over here, you are tightly bonding that this CSS will be applied. That's why you, whenever you are writing something over here, CSS, then this HTML getting affected. Why? Because you have specified over here. Okay. Now, it is a selector that is a unique name. Using this unique name, you can call this component anywhere where you use it. So you have to call the component. So there is a two part, creating a component and calling the component. So you have to call this component. So I have called this component in over here, see, inside body. So this is the unique name. See, you have a unique name. So if unique name is something like, take an example, Raj 123. Then, so you have given this name. So using this name, you can place this component wherever you want. So if I want to place over here, okay. So I want, so you can place. So anywhere you want, you can place. This is so much flexible. Once you create, create is another part. By creating, you won't be able to see in the browser. You have to call that. So if you go to browser again, say that option is same. Okay, now this is the basic understanding you have. Now how it start, from where the things journey start to start it. Okay, so the very first thing that is execution start is from here, main TS is the very first thing that your execution start with. So over here, see, you have a bootstrap module, bootstrap. Then before going into that, let me make you understand one more file that is important. So there is a modules.ts, that this is a global file. This is not a specific to component. This is a like a master module file that register all your components. So whatever component you create, it a reference will come over here. A reference will. So see, you have a one component over here, app component. So in a module, you have a
can you go back? So first I create my HTML, like the component, or for example, say the app component. The app component name can be any name, right? It's not standard that I have to use only app component. I can also say Shiva component or something like that. But this will be declared in the app component.ts file, right? Can you go to app component.ts?
Correct. I am going to create a component, so don't worry. I will create a component and it will make things very easier for you.
Okay.
So let me show you that. 1 minute. Okay. So you have to understand this module file, what it is. So whatever component you create, one component, 10 component, 1000 component, it will come automatically over here. Okay. So, and it is written over here, then it come under declaration section. So you have a one component, it will imported here, then it will be tagged in declaration section. So this is how it works. Now, let me go and show you how the execution starts. So the journey starts from here. Main TS. So main TS has a bootstrap module. So bootstrap module, you have given app module. Where is app module? App module is here, this one. So you go to app module. You have to catch one by one. So you have an app module over here, right? In an app module itself, you have a bootstrap component. So as I told you, in your application, it might be 1000 component, but there will be one component that will show first time in the browser, right? So you have to make that you have to specify a component that will be a starting component. Okay. Component that will be a starting component. Okay. So it is your root component. It is the entry point into your application. So in a Java, if you develop a console application, then there is a main function, right? So that is the starting point. The same way, this is a starting point. It will start from here. So you have a bootstrap component. It is called root component. It is also called root component and a master component, a starting component, or bootstrapping. In a question interview, they ask, what is bootstrapping? So you have to define this process, that putting a component under app module against bootstrap element is called bootstrapping. So now you have this component and then it's defined.
Can I interrupt you? I'm sorry, Shiva. So can I have more than one bootstrap, or it's always only one?
So I'm coming to that. Okay. I'm coming to that. Is a more complex. You are going into intermediate level suddenly. Okay. So yes.
No. It's just my curiosity. If should I always have to have only one? Because you said that it's a starting point, right? Then I'm confused. Maybe I should have only one or something like that.
Yeah. So normally it is one. But wherever you see this bracket, a square bracket, is that you can specify comma separated more than one. It means that if you are not eligible for to put more than one, then it will be like this, only one. So wherever you see this square bracket, it giving that you can put more than one.
Then. Then Shiva, then if it's more than one, the order of the execution or the order of bootstrapping, how it's done, or first in a sequential or in a.
Yeah, so I'll come to that later, but just for your answer.
Sorry, I'm not even intermediate. I mean, it's just my curiosity. That's it. I really don't know about Angular. That's why.
Yes. No issue. So yes, you can have that, but believe me, in any real world, they put one. So that it does not mess up. Okay, otherwise it's become hard to control it. It bring lots of complexity. So people put one only, and you should stick to that only. But yes, wherever this is a square bracket, it indicates that you can have more than one. Just understand for your reference. Okay. Now, so you have app mode.
Sorry, Shiva. So in the declarations we say the app component, and then in the bootstrapping we say. So is it for example, like in declarations, if I have app component one, app component two, app component three, just some up to five, and then in bootstrapping, mandatory that I have to specify all declarations, or can I just say starting point?
Yes, correct, correct. Okay, so see,
I didn't understand. It was my question. I mean, should I say just one? I mean, it doesn't matter that declaration should be like, if in declarations, if I have a three declarations, it doesn't mean that I have to add those three declarations in the Bootstrap. No, right?
No, only one. Okay, only one.
Okay,
so okay, that will be very much clear when we create another component, so don't worry. So just I want you to understand that execution is start from the main TS. In the main TS, you have a Bootstrap module that from here you go to here, and from here you go and see that which is my starting point, and then you got to know that it is your app component that is a starting point, this one, and then you see that which is my HTML and CSS, then you find that it is my HTML and CSS, then same will be displayed under the index. So see, you Angular is called single page application, ESPA. Okay, why? Because there is a one HTML page over here. See, one HTML page which has a body. No other HTML will have a body. See, this HTML doesn't have any body. This is just a div in your any HTML page. There will be one body only, right? Div can be multiple, but body will be the one only.
One. Yeah.
The same reason you have an index page, you have a one body. See, one body, one HTML proper. Okay, and all component is equivalent to div, like div structure. Just you have to plug and play. Okay, now you have a that's why it is called single page application, because you have a single page that has a body structure. Okay, that's fine. Now go and create a component that will clear your most of the confusion. So let me close all this thing. Save it. Okay, now go and create one component. So how you will do? ng g means generate, or you can put generate, you can put full name generate, but g is just sufficient, and I am telling raj one, but you can give any name that you want, header, footer, whatever. Okay, so it's telling that generate command required to be run in an Angular project. Why? Because you are under Raj path, but your project is in transit demo, so you have to move into that. Okay, just try to understand that error, Raj demo. So now you are under your project. Now run ng g and a project name Raj one. So it will create three file. Why? Because Angular know that component means three file. Okay, so Raj one not found it, this one should be there, right? Okay, sorry, ng g and c, you have to specify c. G means generate, c means component, and then Raj one. So see, you created four files, but in which there is a testing file that you do not require. So in a Raj, you can see you have this four files. So testing is not required. So let me delete. It is not required for you currently. So it created three file automatically. CSS, HTML, Raj works. The output is that, and then you have a TS. And again, see the structure over here. It has a selector that uniquely identify. It has a template. It has a style. Okay, and all the classes over here, constructor and everything. Now in a browser, you can go and see the Raj works is not displaying. Why? Because as I told you, that creating a component is a one part, and using the component and calling the component is another part. So you have to call this component. Selector is the unique name, right? So using selector, you will call it. So let me call from here. So how you will call? This is a way to call a component. This is how you will call a component. Okay, so you want to place this component over here, or anywhere you want to, you have to write like that. So see over here, just let me save it.
Control. But don't we have to import this component in the app module or something like that, or not required?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. So Raj one work is the output is there. Now Angular is so clever that it will import automatically. So see, Raj one is imported, and Raj one is put under declaration section automatically. You do not have to worry about that. Just make sure that it is there. So app module is a registry, like at the gate of your building. There is a
Shiva, I interrupt you. So whenever I create a component, it automatically add that declaration to app module, you mean?
Yes, correct. In the app module, it put everything. So you do not need to worry about, okay? So
So it only adds the declaration, but it will not add anything to the Bootstrap. Only in the declaration section it adds.
Correct. Okay. Because in a Bootstrap, normally it is one component. That's why they will not add. All the component that you will keep, it will import here, it will add under declaration. It will import, it will put under declaration. Okay? Mm-hmm. So be aware of that. So like if you are creating a component in your Visual Studio Code, then it will add automatically. But when you are copying and pasting from your friend a project, like friend has created and friend telling that, hey, I am giving component, sending, just add in your project. Then you have to make sure that you have to copy paste under app and also come to Bootstrap module and import and put over here. When you are copying pasting, you have to do this thing. Otherwise, Angular take care of this. Okay, so be aware of that. So what is my goal? My goal is to make you understand what is a component. Component is nothing but a combination of three files: CSS, HTML, and TSS. TSS is the file where you write the TypeScript related code, you create a variable, you create a method, and do all the things. And on top of TSS file, there is a template URL, a style URL, over there you specify your HTML and CSS, and you have a selector that uniquely identifies that component, and using selector only you can call wherever you want it. Okay, whenever you create a new project or a new component or a new service, it come under get register over here, import under declaration section automatically. Bootstrap has a single component always. Normally people put, but yes, this is an option. You can, you know, increase it, but that bring complexity and lots of things. So people go with one Bootstrap only. Okay. In a index
Is it a good practice to keep only one in Bootstrap?
Yeah, this is how we work. So only one only.
Okay. I also have one more question. For example, in appcomponent.html that we have seen in the TS, appcomponent.ts, in that I don't see any constructor added, but the latest one that we have created, it has the constructor added to it. Can you tell me why that appcomponent.ts doesn't have the on innate constructor, but the latest ones has?
Okay, so you are asking that this one, why it is has an ng on init and why the component doesn't have. Okay, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so there is no such a difference over here. When I will take a class for that, what is the significant ng on init, like it is called component lifecycle. So when I will take that class, I will tell you the significant, but there is no such thing. If it is the requirement, then you can manually import and you can create. But this is how the Angular is set up. Like at the very first time, they do not want to bring the complexity. Okay, so that you can get started, you can understand. If Angular put lots of things over here, the first time learner will be confused, right? So the get started, this is a get started project, right? When you are creating a project, this is a starting project so that you can run and feel the experience and go ahead. So at the very first step, nobody want to keep you a pressure. But yes, the question you ask, there is no such difference. According to requirement, you can put it, okay? And even if I do not need it, I can delete it also, okay? I can delete that part, okay? And if you require, I can add manually. So it is not that it is a hard and fixed rule. So now if you have any question, then please go ahead.
Oh no, that's the only thing. I mean, it's just my curiosity why he did add and why he did not add it to the app component.ts. That's it.
No, it's like you join the company first time, first day, they do not tell you everything, right? They give you some basic things.
That's true, but you are still curious to know what the company does and everything. So
yes. So yes, when I take a component lifecycle class, I will make you another, there is a life cycle, an ng on init is a life cycle event. Okay, life cycle event. So I will take in detail. So see, this will be my approach, truly practical, truly hands-on, less theory, more hands-on. Okay, and I am an Angular guy, like I am working on Angular for last 6 years. Okay, I have a total experience of more than 10 years, and currently I'm working in project like in this Angular is there. So I know that what knowledge you need to work on Angular, what challenge you will face, what is the architecture. So I know in and out, and I have trained more than 4,000 professionals so far. Okay, so don't worry about
No, Shiva. I mean, I'm just asking you because I really don't know, and then I'm just going to start with the 8. That's why I'm a bit curious to know.
Let me tell you one thing. Be very much, you are a beginner, that's why you're asking like that. So what is the current version of Java? I learned Java till it was like, I think 8 or something.
Well, actually now it's going to be 9, but in my project we are using still Java 8 Lambda functions, but
Suppose there is a Java version 2 and then Java version 9. What is the basic difference? The basic difference
is the only advancement and then removal of some old functions and then give you the more, I mean, less usage of writing codes and then use the built-in functions.
Yes, so they are adding more and more built-in function, and you can call that library. They are keep in every version, they are adding more and more library. But are they changing the fundamental that was in Java 2? No, right?
No.
So Angular is like that. Angular 8 means every version they are adding more capability, more library to it. But any person who know Angular 2 can work on Angular 8 also. If you know Angular 8, you can work from Angular 2 onward to Angular 8. Even you can work on Angular 10 also. But you won't be able to use that extra functionality that is provided in that specific version. So don't get confused about the version, okay? I will make sure that you are very much comfortable. So see, your responsibility will be to give 100% whatever assignment I give you, whatever lab I give you, you do that, whatever demo I show you, do yourself. This will be your responsibility. My responsibility will be to make you master in the Angular, give you a practical sense. Okay, that's it.